night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Echo in my soul. Soul. In every season, you keep repeating promises to me.
Raise one hand high, throw your light in the sky. We're Good morning, guys. I am so glad that you're back with us this morning. I wish we were on a real beach right now, I'll be honest with you. I'm so glad it's finally getting a little bit warmer and we can be outside more. I hope you're taking advantage of that. You can send us some pictures about what you've been doing, or even just write in the comments some ideas of some games maybe your friends can play outside, or the things that you've been enjoying. But if you've been with us for Wake Up and Worship each day, you know that we're learning about how God knows us, He chose us, and He has a plan for us. We really started looking at this with the story of Jonah this weekend. Our theme this month is Get Up and Go, how we are supposed to get up and go tell everybody about Jesus, live out the Great Commission like we saw last month. And we see this in Jonah's life. He is given a job by God to go somewhere. He's supposed to get up and do it. We know he disobeys and he doesn't do the job at first. We'll learn more about that later this month. But yesterday, we talked about how God has a plan for us too. And sometimes that's hard because we can't see the whole plan at once. But the Bible tells us that God can. He sees our whole life before we were even born. And so we can trust that His plan for our life is best. We're supposed to trust Him with that and not try to take over and go our own way. We learned that our own way can lead us into sin, which causes trouble in our life. And so I want you to go back to kind of that picture I gave you yesterday. You're riding in a car and God is the driver. You're in the passenger seat. You don't know where you're going. You can kind of look out the window and see where you're at. You don't know how long you're going to be in the car or what you're going to do when you get there. And that's what following God's plan is like. Sometimes we don't know the end of the story. We know just the part we're in right now. Sometimes, especially when we're young, we make the mistake of thinking that God's plan for our life starts when we're older. Maybe in the context of our story, you think God's plan for you starts when the car turns off and you finally arrived and get to climb out. But you never want to climb out of God's car. He's the driver. He knows where you're going. He's taking you to the next place. His plan for you never ends. And so if we wait until we get there, we'll never get started. God's plan for you is not about the job you'll have when you're a grown-up or if you'll get married and how many kids you have. Certainly, He has a plan about those things. He's seen what will happen. But God's plan for you is about you loving Him and obeying Him and doing what He says right now. And so if you go back to being in the car with God, there are certain things that you're supposed to do right now. Like if you're actually in a car, you're supposed to wear your seatbelt. I don't know if you know this, but there's kind of a road trip rule that whoever is in the passenger seat is supposed to be the one that takes control of the radio. It wouldn't be safe for the driver to do that, so you're in charge of that too. Maybe God needs a snack. And so you gotta open the bag of chips and help Him out. Like you have jobs to do right now, even in the car as you're waiting to get there. That's kind of a silly example, right? Because we're not actually in a car and God's not asking you to open a bag of chips, I don't think. But His plan for you right now does involve certain things that you're supposed to be doing. And to figure that out, what is God's plan for you right now? I want to look back at Psalm 139, the chapter that we've been in all week long, to see that. It says at the end of the chapter, the last two verses, verse 23 and 24, say, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. Point out anything in me that offends you, and lead me along the path of everlasting life." I gave you the example yesterday of David and how God chose him to be king when he was just a young boy. David knew that there was a plan for him to be king. He didn't know when it would start, and he didn't know everything he was going to need to know when he got there. God taught it to him as he went. We saw that yesterday. But that wouldn't have happened if David didn't do his part. God brought Goliath, and somebody was supposed to fight him. Remember, nobody wanted to. Well, if David just decided that he wasn't going to fight Goliath either, he wouldn't have learned that lesson. He had to do his part. And so as you're trying to follow God and do your part, this is really what that looks like. Verses 23 and 24 of Psalm 139, where it says, "Search me, God, know my heart." That's spending time in prayer and asking God to look inside of you. It says, "Test me, know my anxious thoughts, point out anything in me that offends you, and lead me on the path of everlasting life." Your job right now as you're in the car with God, let's say, is to ask God, "Hey, what's in my life that doesn't belong? What's in my life that I need to get rid of before I can do your plan for me?" When David was king, he couldn't go into that job with acting the way that he acted when he was just a young boy. God had to teach him things, and he had to change and grow as his follower so that he was ready for the job. Now that you're a follower of Jesus, you have to do the same thing. You have to ask God to change you and help you grow as his follower so that you're ready to do the job that he has for you as he shows you it. The job right now might just be kind of like opening the bag of chips, like being a good son or daughter, obeying your parents, being nice to your siblings, doing your homework, getting your schoolwork done. All of those are jobs that God asks you to do right now. And sometimes we think they're not important because they're too small. But God is watching you in those small jobs because he's getting you ready for something bigger. So as you do the small jobs, do them well. And then ask God, is there anything that I did wrong here? Should my attitude be different? Can I live for you better? Show me that from the Bible, or show me that through your Holy Spirit, or show me that through my teachers at church and my parents at home. God'll do it. Read Psalm 139, verses 23 and 24 today. And I want you to do it all alone, kind of like a prayer to God. If you're too little to read, that's okay. Your parents can read it to you too. But spend some time praying and asking God to really show you what in my life doesn't belong. Because that's what he wants to take care of right now. If you don't know what else to do, getting rid of sin and the stuff that doesn't belong is a job for today. And so take care of it. God will show you. He wants to get rid of those things because he's getting you ready for the plan he has for your life. Remember, we saw from Jonah that God knows you and he has a plan for you. He chose you for that job. And so start getting ready. Pray this prayer. And when God shows you something in your life that doesn't belong, say sorry for it and don't do it again. Get rid of it. Follow him because you're getting ready for the bigger job that he has for you as soon as he shows it to you. I'll see you tomorrow as we talk more about that at 9:45.